What's up, guys? Sean here from SRKCycles.com. We have a beautiful 2002. What is this? Can you guess? I know what it is now. Yamaha V-Star 1300. And the guy's got a lot of chrome pieces on here. It actually looks pretty good. He's got the bags. He's got Cobra pipes. He's got the radio. This is actually a Bluetooth setup. He actually showed me a print-up. He spent around $2,000 and doing stuff to this bike. There's the choke. There's the key. Starter clutch is good. This bike does not have that issue. And it's got the windshield, and these are great bikes. They really are. Put the choke in. Guys, let's start the day like we should. Word to wisdom, Psalm 143:10. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Let your good spirit lead me on level ground. Let your good spirit lead me on level ground. All right, so we're gonna go over the cool little gadgets and the Bluetooth and all that stuff on the walk around video. This is a test drive video. I'm just gonna show you how good this thing runs. I already took the choke off. This thing's at just under 15,000 miles, 14.7. And no joke, we have the paperwork showing that this thing is sitting at, this thing's like, he guys spent $2,000 just in aftermarket parts on it. You know what? This is a very popular bike. They sold a lot of these things, and from like when they came out in like the early 2000s to like 2009 or some a pretty good length, they were just, it was a popular bike. People really liked them. And the good thing is, they're reliable, they're cheap, they look good. It's a good bike for an adult to learn how to ride on and not spend a bunch of money. You talk to a lot of guys, even Harley riders, a lot of guys who are like, yeah, I started out riding a V-Star 1100 because it's a good size displacement bike, and they not much to complain about. Now, they do have a starter clutch issue, which costs around, it's expensive. Depending on where you go, I've heard anything like $700 to $900 to fix. If you do it yourself, it's like $450. The parts are expensive. But normally by this time, you know if it has a starter clutch issue. Now, if you were looking at one that had like 2,000 miles on it and sat for a long time, it's like, well, who knows? If you look at one with higher miles, and you know it's definitely either been fixed or it's never had the issue. I won't sell them if it has a bad starter clutch without disclosing that, because I know it's a big problem. I know it's kind of a big deal. I've not tried the radio, but there's a hookup dangling around somewhere for an auxiliary, but then also you can also do a Bluetooth, and the switch is right down here. The bike runs good. The guy drove like 2 hours to get it to me. He bought a Venture. He just wants something bigger, and I get it. This is kind of more like it could be a touring bike for maybe a smaller guy or for someone just getting into it, and they don't care about comfort as much because they don't know any better. I feel like I'm sitting a little close. My legs are a little bent. I'm a little cramped. If you're looking for if you're a taller guy looking for an entry level bike, you know, this could be it. But I would probably want to push you more towards a Vulcan 900. Although I've known big, like 6'4 guys that started out their first bikes were V-Star 650s, and they rode them for a while, and they were fine. Whatever floats your boat, man. Alright guys, that wraps up the test drive. We got some other boxes of parts and cool stuff for this bike. It looks good. It's got a little dent in the tank somewhere. The little one, I don't know. I don't even see it. That's how bad it is. That's how minor it is. They're right there. If you wanted to get it out, someone could, but you probably, like, who cares? Whatever, it's a cheap bike. We're gonna list it for $3,500. And if you want it, let us know. Alright guys, that wraps up the test drive for this 2002, I think it is, V-Star 1100 Classic. The Classic has the big fenders, the Custom has the short fenders, and it's pretty consistent across the board that most people like the Classic better. Caleb likes the Custom. He had a Custom. He loved it. What's going on, sir? You're on the wrong side of the road, man. How dare you? All right, guys. Remember, it's not what you're riding, but where you're going.